Well, it seems no one is safe from Australia's cost of living crisis, not even Pig the Dugong, who lives at Sydney's SeaLife Aquarium and eats up to 40 kilograms of cod lettuce every day. And with prices still sky high, it's costing his keepers a whopping $18,000 a month to maintain his diet. Senior keeper Dayna Plater joined us earlier. Dayna, 40 kilos of cod per day. There's supposed to be a shortage. How are you finding all that lettuce right now, let alone affording it?
Yeah, hi. We are super lucky. We have a great supply here for our dugong. So we get a large supply of lettuce across New South Wales from a variety of different farmers, and they love Pig the Dugong.
Ooh. Dayna, why is this dugong so obsessed with lettuce? Shouldn't it be eating something more like oceany in vibe? Lettuce just seems like our thing. Why is the dugong having our stuff?
Yeah. So the dugong's natural diet is seagrass. Unfortunately, here in Australia, it is a critically endangered plant. So it's actually a protected species. That's fantastic for wild dugongs. But it means for our dugong here that he has to live on a substitute diet. And that went through a trial and error process when he first came into care as a rescue dugong. He went through a process of trying all different leafy greens, and the cod lettuce was his favourite. And, of course, he has a bit of champagne taste. He loves the most expensive kind of lettuce.
Do you know what the process is to get lettuce on the endangered list?
I reckon it'll encourage Pig to eat a few more kilos every day. That might make it happen.
Dayna, KFC has turned to cabbage as a lettuce substitute. Could you try that with Pig?
Unfortunately not. Now, Pig is a VIP, we call him a very important pig, and he only deserves the best of the best. And so the cod lettuce is top quality for him, so of course we have to offer it for him.
It is a heck of a lot of money. Is there a point at which you start to ask whether this investment's worth it?
We never question it here. Pig is 100% worth it. He's the only male dugong in care in the world. You can't find him anywhere else. He's also a really intelligent animal and a great ambassador for his species.
Do you reckon it sounds like you're treating this dugong like some sort of god. Maybe if you treated him a bit meaner, maybe he'd accept a lower standard of food?
Unfortunately not. If anything, he's the one that's treating us a little bit mean sometimes. We have to feed him on average every 10 minutes from the hours of 7:30 to 4 p.m. And if it's not there by the 10-minute mark, he's often picking his tray up, putting it on his back, bringing it up to the surface and showing us that it's empty and he's ready for a new one.
Dayna, I get it. I'm a proud owner of a designer dog, a Cocker Spaniel, so I know that they appreciate it and who's in charge. But tell us, like, how much does he actually appreciate this bougie lifestyle that he's afforded?
This guy appreciates it like no one else. So when Pig was first rescued, he was brought into care, rehabilitated and released back into the wild. And then 8 months later, they found him washed back up on the beach, unfortunately severely underweight and in a terrible condition, was brought back into care, and he decided that he didn't want to be a wild animal. He wanted to be hand-fed cod lettuce leaves for the rest of his life.
He's really played the sympathy
card.
Hasn't
he, right? Yeah. Sounds like a good life. Hey, Dayna, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it.
No worries. Thank you so much for having me, guys.
Poor Pig.
I never thought I'd say this, but that dugong is spoiled. You know what I mean?
It just seemed a little high maintenance.
She's like, oh, the dugong wouldn't accept anything. Like, it'll take what it's given. It's literally in a cage. Stop capitulating to the dugong.
I feel everyone's been played, including us.
Yeah. Totally.